Next to Mr. Ziegler is Rachel O'Connell, the only daughter of Vivian Ziegler. And next to Rachel is Reverend Mansu. Let's give a round of applause to him. And then next to Reverend Mansu is Mr. Samuel Teko. Mr. Teko. And then last but not the least is Mr. Nelson Fiato. Let's put our hands together for him as well. Now, we all know why we're here, and this is a celebration. We've flown back to Ghana for, and so if you're here tonight, we're hoping that we will all, through our kind heart, give to support this family as they transition this incredible woman home and give her a befitting burial. I want to be given a befitting burial, and she wants to be given a befitting burial. And so if you're here tonight, I am hoping that we will all, through our kind heart, donate to support this family. Tuma here. They are at the collection table, and they will be collecting money to support this family. So again, do not hesitate. I am hoping that somebody will just write a $100,000 check and they will call it a night. Right? Who can leave? Jesus.
message from them, Lord.
Thank you.
Vivian was here, I can guarantee you that she'll be on the floor dancing. That when it's time for us to dance, I'm expecting everyone to get up and dance. We've been sitting all day. Shake yourself up. Come up and told about a bus driver who was driving. And then all of a sudden, somebody tapped his back. He got so scared that he started screaming. He said, "Driver, driver, what's going on?" He said, "I thought I had a dead body behind me because I've been driving for 25 years driving funeral vans." We are not here to be scared of anything. We heard the preaching today, right? That death is a gateway to eternity. So we are here to celebrate. That when we're ready to dance, please, we get let's get up and celebrate Vivian. She wants her life to be celebrated. She wants her life to be celebrated. We had a daughter when she gave the tribute. She said, "Vivian was very resourceful. Vivian was very resourceful. Engage and dance and make her feel happy for the life that she's led." So at this point, DJ, let me give us a song so folks can come up and dance. Give us a song. This is one of our favorite songs, so let's all I think folks are a little hungry. So what we're going to do is, we have food. We have food. I want to thank everyone who worked hard, dedicated themselves and preparing this food. What I want to do is to call all those in the kitchen, those who are in the kitchen, to come up here for a second, please. All of you, the folks that are behind the scene, who have worked hard tirelessly last night. I know folks who are cooking. Itakono, please, let's put our hands together for them. Thank you so much. Thank you. Thank you so much. So we have food, and we're going to pray over the food. We are going to
eat it to nourish our body and our soul in the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. And all those who work hard and those who are looking the money comes from, Father, bless them. In the name of our Lord Jesus and our Savior. Amen.
Yeah.
I told you he should just be the MC for the night. I know folks are eating, but as soon as you're done eating, we are going to open this place up so we can celebrate Vivian. I know folks drove all the way from New York, and we thank you for driving all the way to mourn and celebrate Vivian's life. She meant a lot to us, and that's why we're here tonight. So when we're done eating, I know mouths are busy, Dad. We'll excuse you for that. But once it's all said and done, we want everybody here, and we'll have an opportunity for tributes as well. So be prepared. So eat and eat well. Thank you. I was just told that this is one of Vivian's favorites, Akpaja. So if you're done eating, I'm going to ask folks to start making their way to the dance floor. This is Vivian's favorite. Micho. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you. At this time, we'd like to recognize a few people again. As I said earlier, the folks that drove all the way from New York, I would like to recognize them. New York, let's all say a big thank you and put our hands together for those who came all the way from New York. We also, New Jersey. Also, we have in our midst the presiding elder of the Apostolic Church of Ghana, all the way from Hartford, Connecticut. Wow. Came all the way from Hartford, Connecticut. Elder Alfred Opari Dako. Elder Alfred Opari Dako came all the way from Connecticut. He just left, but I wanted to make sure that we recognize him. He said that Vivian meant a lot to him, and that's why he came all the way from Connecticut to pay his last respect. At this time, we want to say a few tributes to our sister, our mother, our grandmother, our auntie, our legacy on this earth. And so we're going to open the floor and have folks come up and say a few things that they remember, some of the experiences that they've had with our sister. He took the mic. What is the legacy? What are our legacy? She's done hers. She's left her, lived her life. She lived it well. She's gone. Opportunity for us to also share a few testimonies that we encountered with Vivian. So I'll call on my brother, a former Micah, and give us a tribute for Sister Vivian.
Those days when I was a young man, we traveled to Boston for functions and funerals. She's the one who hosts me and my partner. She'll make sure whatever is needed is given. Now, when I heard she passed away, she whispered to me with a message. The message is, it's been written in a song called the Yes Man Law. But on your name, Tao Machinuvom to Jokam, Yahola Vivian, the Lamania, Malone, the Yes. Lord Jesus, I love you. Now, this message was written out of the context of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ's last visit. This message was written out of the composer of this song. Wrote this message out of the last visit of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. The last visit that he visited his disciples, they were at the shore fishing, and they never knew he was going to be there. So he stood and he was watching, looking at them. So when he realized that they were in difficulty of catching fish, what did he say? He asked them, did they have any catch? They said no. So he told them, they should throw the net to their right, which they did, and they had a bumper catch. So as soon as they pulled out the net, a fire was set at the corner, and he said they should put some fish on it. So they did that, and after dining, he asked Simon Peter, Simon, do you love me? He said, I put on my love. Lord, I love thee. He asked him three times. In our normal human life, if someone asks you the same question three times, you get pissed off. You ask, Baba Man, no, look at that job. But he took it calmly, he said, Lord, I love thee. So the message the Lord Savior Jesus Christ gave him was that, if you love me, take care of my lambs. Who are those that he's talking about? It's we, the normal people who are in light. So Sister Vivian is telling me to give this message to all of us today that we should love one another. We should stop the backbiting. If your brother has done something bad to you, no. Go to the person and so, Sister, ni mo rangore, a chobaya, mere kuku, take him. So the songwriter who wrote the song said, "Ne Yesu melo, tau me chinu vong di joken, ne kola vevi ne la ne ne melo Yesu." Yesu melo, oh beto, ne tau me chinu vong di joken, me chinu vong di jo.
I don't have anything to say more than what my daughter has already said. She had already given a glowing tribute to the mother. But for me, I'm here just to thank Vivian. I thank her for marrying me. And also I thank her that through her, I inherited a daughter, Rachel here, and 5 grandchildren. Amen. My family is increasing. Amen. And also a very kind son-in-law, Mr. Felix O'Connor. He's in Ghana. And I said, in this day, I said, okay, all the rewards of the good and the sacrificial works that he did for the family, to her Lord and the community, should precede her. Amen. To heaven. And now I'm telling her now formally that farewell, Edenye.
Thank you. Is Abu here? Please do me a favor. Say, can you please enlighten this audience with your talented voice, your voice? I need that. Please. Those of you who know the song, please join in. Listen to the words. That's all it's about. Love thy neighbor as thyself. That's all. We all have handicaps. I may not be perfect, but the overriding factor is love. Vivian might have offended you. So what? Have you offended anybody else? Love.
Oh, Lord.
Thank you. We are going to be calling on you again, so please be prepared. One more of those songs.
So happy to be here, and the church, Apostle Revelation Society Church also, to be present. But one thing we have to know, as I see tears coming from the eyes of the bereaved family, one thing, your mother, the husband, to the wife says something that do not shed tears. Because the one who loved her, he is the one that called him, that called her. So do not shed tears. Do not shed tears. In occasion like this, there is no worth of among your neighbor, your friends, a human being who say to comfort you. But I know someone who Jesus Christ, who called your mother, the wife, sister, auntie, saying he will wipe away tears. So at this point, I know and I pray that Almighty God wipe away your tears.
Amen.
Wipe away your tears. Before I continue something again, I will call the ARS Church to come again for some song, then we can continue. But one thing, you know, as we all know, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. So when you remember this, then your tears will be wiped away. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. So why are we going to shed tears? Because she in the a very nice and a very nice hand love for you now. You thank God. God, I thank you. Amen. God, I thank you.
Amen.
Let me back.
Have folks with such an incredible voice to sing to the glory of God, and also to Vivian. I am sure Vivian is smiling and singing along as well.
I hope you're all awake. Rest assured, someone is coming here in some few minutes to tickle your mind. This time is, I told you before, is not a time for eating and drinking. What have you learned from this? You see, I'm not the person that we learn every day. My daughter teaches me every day. When you come to gatherings like this, you learn every day. What legacy has been left? You learn from that, from the MC. Love. What else? Listen to Reverend Kofi.
We're asking that you dig deep down your pocket and try and help this family give Vivian a befitting final burial. Yo, Reverend Kofi.
Maraka mo kwasi pa namore. Well, what I'm about to say, it will be in Ewe. Because I'm a Igbe. I was born at Igbe. I will live at Igbe. When I die, God will judge me like a Igbe. Amen. So, first of all, I will say a little story in English. And then after that,
you come to Igbe.
I will dive straight into a Igbe. But, well, we will leave the French for today. Okay. This story is about death. A man was so smart, so clever, that he planned to trick death so that he would never die. So the best way to do that is to be death's servant. So he went to him and he said, I can take care of this house. I will sweep for you. I will wash your dishes. I will iron your clothes. I will do everything that I can do so I will not die. So he started. He did a lot. So one day, Dad said, I will be traveling. And he left his files and everything. Death is capable of saying, I'm taking this one today, I'm taking that one tomorrow, date and everything. And then, Death said, I'll be traveling. And I'm about to give you this key, this bunch of keys, so you can take care of this place, my office and everything. He said, okay. And it happened that he traveled. And the guy, the servant, closed all the doors. He locked all the doors. And he came to Death's office where he had all the files lined up to see who is going next. And he was shocked to see that he was next in line. So he said, what? With everything that I've been doing for this guy, He has no pity on him. So you know what he did? He looked. There was nobody there, so he looked for a razor, and he went like this. He raised his name and put the name at the bottom. So he finished everything and then put the file back somewhere. Then, after 3 months, the boss of the house knocked. Mr. Death came. Hi, how are you? I'm fine. How's everything? Everything is normal. Everything is at its normal place. And Death said, hi. He went into his office and he said, I'm about to start my job. Who is going to be next? And he didn't touch the fire. And he was thinking. And he said, you know what? I'm my own boss. I do whatever I want. Today, instead of starting from the top, I'll start from the bottom.
Amen. Amen.
So you can never please this guy called Death. That's the moral of the story. Without any delay, we will go into Ewe. Enyama vela sinye ike motima magblo wetroya. Enyakbanto enye amejibola. Enyavelia enye amejicherefo nubrame nyao.
Amen. Father.
Amenibola, fiye ya fafela foto anibaji, belite nuba bokata unti, e wole jicho dimcho, anibala fa babaji jome. Wefa ke klese se la nou yivo, vovone nuba bokata, hiya mezino do tonton, lele isi amamedi chano, duago do le tolo polopo, fisi tobi tobi yo, ple mama mama odom anoma vado, jo ble make vasele gbesia, pour me tendre un coup de dire peuple à titre au gaillot d'Oji. Et nous, si qu'on domine, quand c'est au dé des silamas, pourquoi pas bonheur, il connaît bien. Oji le vrai simé. Et il coule peu que même. Que va bonheur, on signe à mon nom, bouquin. Et que quelqu'un vit un peu, c'est au dit qu'on roule un cri. Donc le temps, tant qu'il est tout grand, c'est à me. Fiao il fait, gao il fait, auto il fait. Au gâteau, on roule pas bacaome. Et à fois, des au gâteau, ce soit. Demain, il y a un mot. Bemen yuwa ji hao, koko le befon we, gako me fon, ya pa fe poto oji, gako me jome jemo. Longo ku so la gira nyeba me chizwa tika, gake wao ya, ope jomo le tomo kemu. Yato kbato nya fiato, e ya mesi tanko, ple seda, e yo no a chodo do ka me po, mousse, bubu, a glotutu, woka tan no vayi. Pour que tu m'as dit, tu as dit que 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 tu as Yo dosi kwe tona nya fono azinoto. E ya le kamu a shuma kwa be de mono mo dobe kwa ene. E vola, pe de vio dada o nye kwa fi. E vio fo hona kwa do. A me si bona chon nube. E li di na koto be dada kwa la. E ya le kachi yomo e kwe si ya. Va me nuve la me prona me yina de yomo. Mamu nona hanye ke mo a fim da. E ya me si bronya o se te le bedo kome. E ya me si kamona vola.
My friend of 18 years, I've been in this country for 18 years. Vivian, she had been my friend for 18 years. Knowing Vivian, it's like another sister. Having a sister in Vivian, apart from friendship. I'm from Nigeria, she's Ghana, but everywhere we went, they thought we were sisters because we were that close. Vivian is a loving mother, a loving friend, an epitome of kindness, an epitome of beauty, forgiving, and very, very caring. She has been instrumental in my raising my children. When Uncle Zewe said he had 5 grandchildren, I was gonna say, what about my own children? Because Vivian helped me to bring up these children. She is a woman of high integrity, a woman of intellectual excellence, and most of all, she loves God. Amen. She's forgiving, she's giving, and she's what everybody, every person today should aspire to be. I'm gonna miss her. So much I miss her. And I know that I have a solace in Rachel, the daughter. We've been together. The closeness I have with Vivian, I have been able to cultivate with Rachel. And her grandchildren, they are my grandchildren. Woyire, Rachel's daughter, I'm the godmother of Woyire. And I know that even though Vivian has gone to rest with the Lord, I will never, never desert the family, the daughter and the grandchildren, and the husband as well. So I'm gonna sing a short song in her memory. Vivi, Vivi Zewe, Vivian, Vivian Zewe, Vivian, Vivian Zewe, where are you now? Vivian, Vivian Zewe, Vivi, Vivi Zewe, Vivi, Vivi Zewe, you have gone to rest. Holy, 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 Jesus is our comforter.
Amen.
Jesus is our comforter. Jesus is the Lord. Jesus is our comforter. Jesu woga usushima. Jesu woga usushima. May you rest in peace.
Amen.
Thank you.
Tradition. Before I say anything else, I would like to acknowledge the contribution, the donation made by the ARS of New York and New Jersey. They made a contribution of $1,000 to help put this together. The reason why I have to make this announcement is sometimes gathering like this, he said, oh, I'm so sorry. But when it comes to putting your hands in your pocket, people start drawing back. They don't want to do it. It's a reality. Don't you agree with me?
Yes.
When the rubber hits the road, you see the reaction of people. So I have to acknowledge that. And from Mrs. Kumanya, thanks to all of you who donated to the funeral expenses and other expenses towards the arrangements of our sister. I know some of you have taken off from work to come here.
Vivian Zibwe. Where are you now? Vivian Zibwe. You have gone to rest.